only have so much time. It is later than you think. Damn it, dog, sir. It's time for the snack, motherfuckers. Topic is inspired by the Reddit YouTube video. I think the topic was something like things that you heard that changed your perspective on life, or changed your life. And you know, that's another way of looking at life on the scale of and the distance of death. And on one hand, yeah, I may want to go party up, shoot up some heroin, and vote Hillary. Fuck it, just YOLO. But on the other hand, I say, I'm not that destructive. Let's create, lead by example, and make shit happen. And it's a challenge at times because, again, not only if it just took you to a dog walk, but if I could show you all the places that I've been to. And I'm seeing this one YouTube video. News cameras went to go interview a mom that had her daughter who was killed. They were going through family footage before the murder. Okay, now, after the murder, she's all dolled up, talking about her daughter, and then missing her. But then it goes back to old family footage, and she's just laying on the couch, just being a fucking big fat-ass whale. And I thought, you know, did you realize that death was nearby, man? Or did you just never... I'm gonna live forever. And this is another video title that I thought of a minute ago. Something very depressing. We're all gonna die. But on the bright side, we're all gonna die. And no, I'm not one of these motherfuckers that's all emo. Life's so sad, what's the point? Let me cut myself. Let's torture little animals. No. But I just had some cold tea and some food. And the food was it processed but organic. It came out of a wrapper, but it was organic. And some cold tea, and I thought it was awesome. And I think on one hand, I could look at it and be like, fuck, man. I've been here and done this and that. And That's all I have. I guess I could look at it like that. Then I think, you know, this is just another step on the journey. And I think some of us, I know I did for a long time, didn't see the, you know, not until I earned this title that I began to even grasp or was even introduced into the idea, the thought of potential, of the word potential. Because I do reflect on that. The quality and quantity of food in my refrigerator. My diet, the things that, the tools that I, extra tools, newer tools, more tools I would like. Travel plans that are on standby. And, you know, a lot of the mediocrity that people have accepted, that they try to, inject into me when I run into them or communicate with them that, oh man, are you still working on that? Aren't you going to be finished? Aren't you supposed to be a millionaire by now? You know, I've got my shit together because, yeah, I may not be in love, but I'm married. Yeah, I may not be a fucking dedicated father, but at least I'm a parent. Yeah, you know, I may have my dream house, but I got a house in Compton. Yeah, you know, I may not be pursuing my goals, but at least I got the 401k. Fuck that. I'm watching these Bigfoot videos, people who are sharing their stories. And this probably should be a topic by itself, where the UAMN YouTube channel has been deleted. They used to report a bunch of unexplained stuff. Great stories, man. Stories that definitely make me wonder what's there that goes bump in the night, and I think could be this, could be that. But yeah, no, I keep on going because, you know, I know that I'm going to clock out one day. The day will come where I will no longer upload another video. Where I won't be able to. Or probably my hand will be stuck like this from arthritis or tendonitis. And I will barely be able to pick it up like this. And I'll probably start coloring like that. Just because of
loss of control of my hand, its muscles, tendon soreness.
I forgot what I heard the other day, but it's good that I blocked it out. But it was something that was so irrelevant based off what's available today, technology, opportunity, warm tea, hot cocoa, just better times. I know that whatever I did here, it was something that it'd be like me being in a city like Los Angeles, New York, or Chicago, and saying, you know, there's, I could be sent in the dead center of the city and say, you know, and have $100 cash in my pocket and say, man, there's nothing to eat, and it's a clear, sunny sky. Because, the remedy was simply, well, walk towards it, walk towards the answer. Yep, I remember hearing this and I thought, what? Is that possible? Especially when they look like they're going to college. You're in your 20s, when you look like you're in your early 20s with someone else who's in their early 20s, and they have binders and books. I think you're going to college with backpacks. Another thing that's
probably that made me made me up, put it all on, bet it all on black, on red, or on green.
Is when I've had success,
when I've accomplished something great, when I or when I accomplished something that I thought, fuck, really this happened? Like, I won, I made this much. It's like when there's no reference from experience or teacher or mentor to have guaranteed it. I think. All right, cool. This is awesome. I like this victory. Now, what else is possible?
And you know, someone else had asked me about Australia, my time in Australia, and I said, you know what I miss about it the most is literally walking a mile and a half to get to my destination. And the only time that I had to put my guard up was when I was crossing the street that had car traffic on it. Other than that, yeah, I may look out for snakes or spiders. Make sure that the window screens are shut so the fucking mosquitoes. The fucking mosquitoes over there are fucking shit. Fucking memorable. But yeah, here it's, you know, I can go to a store to get a product or service, go visit a friend, go visit a client, go to an art show, and you know, one of the things that's just basic is, right, where am I at? If I can find parking, when I find parking, and pay attention to my surroundings. Who's that motherfucker over there? Are those motherfuckers looking there? Are they hanging out? Are they waiting for something? Are they waiting for a delivery? A bus? A taxi? You know, are they wearing fucking warm clothing in summer? Are they wearing hoodies and on purpose? Staying in the shade and the darkness, or away from security cameras and lighting. Remember one time I was in San Diego, and went to go see a shop, and first time there doing business with them, trying to do business with them. And I remember seeing, damn, that's a lot of homeless motherfuckers. That's a lot of homeless people. And I parked maybe 15 to 20 feet away from the entrance, from the door of this business that I'm going to visit. Again, I had already noticed the homeless. For some reason, when I parked, a lot of them stood up from the ground. It felt like some sort of a zombie clip. What the fuck? And, fuck, fight, flight, run, attack, defend,
You know, also when I've traveled, one of the calculations I made is, you know, where else can I head to? What else can I explore? What's new to see? One time I saw this amazing sculpture of an Aztec pyramid. Badass. My battery's running low. Took pictures of it in video for reference, for drawing reference, memory. And I thought, man, this is pretty badass. I don't see it all over social media. I thought, damn, that's... And whoever designed it is a badass motherfucker. And I'm guessing that sculpture will outlive the person who built it and designed it. And when I see stuff like that, but yeah, it does tell me, hey, it's stupid. I'm not stupid. Why doing why fucking acting in a stupid way, stupid small way, and not leaving something behind like this? When will you? What are you? That's it for now. I'm gonna recharge the battery. Trump 2020.